Welcome to Nancy Wilson's Femina Podcast. This audio is brought to you by Canon Press.
Hello, welcome to the Femina Podcast. This is Nancy Wilson. Thank you for joining me today. I thought I would talk to you today a little bit about waiting. And waiting. This is, at least I believe for most all of us, it's a regular feature of our lives, and we're always waiting for something, right? When I was growing up, I'm sure I was waiting for school to start, or for school to finish, or for the cookies to come out of the oven, or waiting for dinner, or waiting for Christmas, or waiting to get over the chicken pox. A childish waiting and a childish impatience, no doubt. But now I'm an adult, and my waiting continues, doesn't yours? We are all waiting for things, it seems like, anyway, all the time. You may be waiting for your due date, for payday, or for a loan to go through, or a house to be finished, or for a surgery date, or the results of a test, or for healing, or for a husband. And then there is all the petty waiting, for a ride, at the red light, waiting to board, waiting to take off, waiting for a late flight. We have so much waiting. That we have waiting rooms, waiting areas, waiting lists, waiting lines. It's a cultural expectation that we will spend lots of time waiting. But it also seems that God wants us to wait. And He wants us to wait in a very specific way, not in a childish way and not in a worrisome adult way. He wants us to wait patiently. And what is patience but waiting with a calm spirit, not a fretful spirit, not an agitated spirit. So patience is basically waiting. So let's look at what the scripture says about waiting. It turns out it says quite a bit about it, but I'm just going to use two verses. The first one is in Psalm 27, 14. Wait on the Lord. Be of good courage, and He shall strengthen thine heart. Wait, I say, on the Lord. And then Isaiah 40, verse 31. But they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. This should give us plenty of material to discuss in terms of waiting and what it means for a Christian to wait. First, you probably noticed, our waiting should be on the Lord, not on the calendar, not on the builder, not on the postal service. Not on people, not waiting on all those things that we have to wait on all the time, but waiting on the Lord. So how do we do this? Well, first we acknowledge that God is in specific control of the calendar, specific control of the deadline and the timing, and He does all things well. Second, we give the specific thing that we are waiting for to Him. And then we wait on Him, not on the thing. It's like we leapfrog over the thing or the person or the whatever it is we're waiting on. We transfer the whole waiting to the Lord, where instead of waiting on this person to do what I ask them to do, and they're very late, we wait on the Lord and say, Lord, I'm waiting on You, on Your perfect timing of when this will be fulfilled. So we're transferring the waiting from the thing to God. It's not an easy thing to do, but we can learn to do this. I'm confident we can practice doing this. So ask for courage for the waiting, and not just courage, but good courage. And He promises in Psalm 27 that He will strengthen our heart. A weak heart cannot wait with courage. It is tapping its foot. It is antsy. It is agitated. But a heart that God strengthens can bear the waiting. And that's what we want. We want to be the women who can bear the waiting and not be impatient and upset or agitated. And the passage from Isaiah 40 tells us that if we wait on the Lord, He will renew our strength. There's the strength again, promised strength. And from this, we can see that waiting requires strength, supernatural strength. We just don't have it in ourselves to wait. And God promises to give us His strength when we turn our waiting from waiting on the thing, we want to waiting on the Lord. Some of you, no doubt, have been waiting a long time. Have you been waiting on the Lord? If not, then I'm sure you have grown weary. So wait on the Lord. Transfer this waiting to waiting on the Lord Most High, your good God. And no matter how long it takes, He will provide the strength and the courage for the journey. In fact, this verse says, you'll mount up with wings as eagles. You'll run and not be weary. You'll walk and not faint. So it's not just persevering, but it is mounting up. It's flying high. It's running and not growing weary. It's an amazing picture. He will transform our waiting from a weary, faint-hearted waiting to something very different, something exhilarating, in fact. So when we wait on the Lord, He transforms our waiting into a victory in itself. We soar like the eagle. We run or we walk and we don't grow weary or we don't faint. We don't give up because we're asking God to renew our strength as long as we wait on Him. So consider the things that you're waiting for. Just spend a few minutes thinking about this. Like, what is it you're waiting for? What are the things that you feel pressure about that you're waiting for continually? The things you've been waiting for long-term, the things you're waiting for short-term right now, and transfer all of these things to the Lord and wait on Him. And sometimes I think as we do this, we might notice that some of the things we're waiting for are sort of petty and silly. And as we give it to God, He gives us a real healthy perspective on these things that we're waiting for. Some of the things we are waiting for are really enormous, and we're asking for big things from God. So transfer all these things to Him. Don't wait on the calendar. Don't wait on the mail. Wait on the Lord. So that's sort of a big order that I'm giving you. And I think it's going to take a little time for you to sort through it and make this transfer. And I think you will find just a real rest and peace that happens when you transfer everything over. And then you can wait on the Lord and you can know that's what He wants you to do. Waiting is good, or He wouldn't tell us to wait on Him. He designed the world in such a way that requires a lot of waiting. And so let's learn to wait with joy and wait on the Lord. Thank you for joining me today, and blessings on your day.